good day, panels. Good day, advisor. So, as we're about to discuss, we'll do it. So, our thesis proposal is entitled Design, Fabrication, and Testing of Speed Breakers Installed with Piezoelectric Harvesters for Farm Systems. So, our content of our presentation will be introduction, review of related literature, theoretical consideration, methodology, and analysis. So, I'm Justin Tamse, and I'm about to discuss chapter one, introduction. So the introduction includes background of the study, statement of the problem, objective of the study, significance of the study, and the scope and limitations. So the background of the study, we have alternative source of energy. So alternative source of energy is a source of energy that is alternative to fossil fuels. And since the alternative energy is not traditional, it has a low environmental impact. Compared to the renewable energy, alternative energy doesn't harm the environment. And compared to the renewable, which may or may not harm the environmental environment. So next is vibrational engineering. Vibrational engineering is applied in the process of designing, fabricating of the speed breakers, which focus on the oscillation of the spring that can help generate energy by continuously applying the force or pressure in the piezoelectric transducer that we will use when a load is applied. So next is the piezoelectric harvesting. So piezoelectric harvesting is harvesting energy by the use of piezoelectric harvester, namely the piezoelectric transducers, which can generate and store energy when a stimulus is applied, like pressure, motion, or vibration. And next is the design, fabrication, and testing of piezoelectric speed breakers. So statement of the problem. So the statement of the problem includes harnessing daily waste mechanical energy. So When a vehicle goes through a speed bump, we know there is a daily waste mechanical energy that can be harnessed by the use of speed breakers that is installed with piezoelectric transducers. So next is the most of the non-renewable energy today emits harmful waste product in the environment, like fossil fuels, where fossil fuels leaves a carbon footprint in the environment. Next is that renewable energy being more expensive compared to alternative source of energy. Next. So the objective of the study. The general objective of the study is to design, fabricate, and test a working speed breaker installed with piezoelectric harvester for powering state labs. So that's our main objective. So next is the specific objective. So to determine and to select the materials available in the local market to be used in the fabrication of the speed breaker installed with piezoelectric harvester. Next is the to design and fabricate a speed breaker installed with piezoelectric harvester that can withstand a weight of 1,500 kg, which is the weight of a normal light vehicle. To test the platform design, if it has the capacity to support and absorb the pressure of the passing light vehicles, will be discussed later. To produce a 120 watt hour of electrical energy to light a 10 watt 12 bulb street lamp in 12 hours of night. So next is the significance of the study. This research aims to know how the daily waste mechanical energy can be transformed into electrical energy that can be used as an alternative source of energy. This study aims to build a functioning piezoelectric speed breaker energy harvester, and this study also promotes road safety, applying speed breakers for regulation for the cars passing through. The scope and limitation. So this study will investigate the viability of harnessing energy from vehicles with the use of piezoelectric speed breakers. And it will be conducted in a subdivision where vehicles maintain a low speed. And a battery will be used as an energy storage and power source for the street lights. And the energy harness will be used to light up the street lights. The circuit that will be used in a is an pre-built integrated circuit. And the limitations. The weight of the vehicle to be used will be up to 1.5 tons. And the vehicle will run less than 20 kph. The location will be set on a street with light to moderate traffic. The piezoelectric transducer will be used, should be available in the local market. So, the next reporter will be Jet Derige, who will be discussing chocolate.
Okay, good morning. I'm going to discuss the chapter 2 of our proposal, which is the review of related literature. Next. Now, these are the related studies that have been conducted for piezoelectric or the harnessing of energy by means of the piezoelectric effect. For the first one, there is a study of the design of piezoelectric energy harvesting and storage devices. And there are also piezoelectric energy harvesting and one small-scale application for everyday use, which is a shoe-embedded piezoelectric energy harvester for wearable sensors. There is a piezoelectric transducer which is placed in the heel, the shoe, that can, that from the pressure of your heel, can be harnessed electricity. There's also power extraction circuits for piezoelectric energy harvesters in miniature and low-power applications. And the modeling design of the street light generation speed breaker mechanism. Now this is for the speed breaker mechanism example of the related studies. Now next. Now let's talk about the related literature. For the scope of the for the proposal, we're going to talk about piezoelectricity, piezoelectric materials, the piezoelectric effect, which is the aftermath of generating the electricity. Vibration energy from the springs that will be used in the design, and basic mechanical energy from the vehicles that go into speed breakers. For the piezoelectricity. Piezoelectricity is a form of coupling between the mechanical and electrical behaviors of ceramics, crystals belonging to certain classes. These materials exhibit the piezoelectric effect, which is historically divided into the two phenomena as the direct piezoelectric effect and the converse piezoelectric effect. This will be discussed later on. Next. Piezoelectric materials. The piezoelectric materials that produce an electric current when they are placed under mechanical stress, such as bending or under pressure. The piezoelectric process is also reversible. So if you apply an electric current to these materials, they will actually change shape slightly with a maximum of 4% of deformation. For example, if you put an electric current to a material, it can also be bended, while vice versa, when you put pressure or just bend it, there will be an electric current. Quartz, leads, zirconates, and titanates have piezoelectric properties that can be applied here. Next one. Okay, this is the piezoelectric basis. Materials exhibit the piezoelectric effect. When a material is mechanically strained, it produces the same strain by electrical charge. The piezoelectric effect can also be reversible, as said earlier. It means that the materials that are exhibiting direct piezoelectric effect also exhibit converse piezoelectric effect. So what do we mean when converse piezoelectric effect? The converse effect is the generation of stress when an electric field is applied. Outer electrical field is either stretches or compresses the piezoelectric material. Next one. Vibration energy. Yes, this is for the springs. Energy harvesting devices used to scavenge energy from ambient vibrations from the environment have been intensively studied during the past few years, mainly because of the need to power wireless devices or to have autonomous solutions to augment the use of batteries. One example for this is the for the train, the switches for an incoming train, there will be a vibration that is generated from the movement and the weight. Therefore, from the sensor, the switch will be switching the lane of the rail, like just like that. Piezoelectricity uses the main concept of vibration energy. As Mr. Tamse said, the oscillation will provide the much needed force that requires the use of the piezoelectric transducers. Future energy harvesters must be able to utilize ambient vibrations in typical environments and not just the vibrations from pumps or motors. And the last one is the waste mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is one of the most ubiquitous energies that can be reused in our surroundings. The sources of mechanical energy can be a vibrating structure, a moving object, a vibration induced by flowing air or by flowing of water. Mechanical waste energy usually can be harvested by using vibration to electricity conversion, and the most distinguished characteristic of this kind of waste energy harvesting is initially identified and used for low power generations only. And that concludes the related review of related literature. And for the next one will be Mr. Gawain Escalona.
So I will be presenting chapter 3 of our proposal, theoretical considerations. Moving on. This will be the context of our theoretical consideration. Piezoelectric energy harvesting, mechanical vibrations, and under that, general equation and system response, and the vibration and system under the system, and electronic components. So, piezoelectric energy harvesting. There are three basic transductions. Namely, electromagnetic, electrostatic, and piezoelectric. So we will be more focused on piezoelectric transduction. Transduction meaning the conversion of one form of energy to another. Moving on, so piezoelectric and piezoelectric transduction has the advantage over large power density. Power density meaning power over volume can also be expressed as watts per cubic meter for macro scale, or milliwatts per cubic centimeter for micro scale. So in terms of application, piezoelectric transduction has a large variation of application, since it can be applied from micro scale to macro scale. Moving on. So mechanical vibrations. We consider vibrations engineering as part of this our research, since we will more likely be studying more about vibratory motions, and from that vibratory motion, we will convert mechanical energy to electrical energy through piezoelectric transduction with the use of transducers. So vibratory motion occurs with the action of external dynamic forces, referred to as free vibration, and those resulting from dynamic external forces are referred to as forced vibration. Now, in this study, we will be more focused on forced vibration. Next. So the general equation and system response. The governing equation and system response of mechanical systems can be particularly represented as equivalent spring mass systems. So x as the one directional coordinate, and also determines as the displacement of the mass. So mass is the mass is attached to the spring, and the k would be the stiffness of the spring, or the spring constant. And t will represent time. So this will be the diagram, spring mass system diagram. And applying a kinetic diagram. So the equivalent force will be determined by the force applied by the spring and the weight of the object. So next, the kinetic diagram can be expressed in the equation negative kx equals to mass times acceleration. This is basically a Hooke's law. Mass is equal to force is equal to the spring constant times the displacement. The negative sign just determines the direction of the force applied by the spring. Upon rearranging the terms and dividing through by m, we obtain the governing equation: acceleration plus natural frequency squared times the displacement equals zero. So omega will be equal to square root of the mass time over the spring constant. So by applying Euler's equation to the general equation, we now have the general solution x of t is equals to a sub 1 cosine omega t plus a sub 2. This would be sine omega t. So a sub 1 and a sub 2 represents the amplitude of the wave representing this equation. So you can actually get the total amplitude by getting the a1 squared plus a2 squared squaring it. So that will give you the total amplitude. And by getting the total amplitude, you will be forced to get also the phase angle. So that will also simplify the equation to just sine or cosine omega. Next, damped vibration systems and underdamped systems. So in the spring mass damper system, unlike the previous diagram, here we add a damper to counteract the force of the spring so that it won't continually vibrate. So applying Newton's second law of motion for the one-dimensional problem, we will get this equation. So there's an additional dumping force here. The spring force, dumping force, and the equivalent force for that. So by manipulating again the equation, we get this general equation. So this dumping factor represents the dumping coefficient. Yeah. Nice dumping factor. This represents the dumping factor and is equivalent to the dumping coefficient over 2 omega m. So it can also be represented as this one. So next, we know that square root of the dumping factor is less than 1, which represents an underdump system having the general equation of x of t is equals to e raised to negative the dumping factor times omega t multiplied by the quantity a sub 1 cosine omega t plus a sub 2 sine omega t.
omega dt. Omega dt is the damping frequency, which represent, which is then equal to the natural frequency times the square root of 1 minus the damping factor squared. So next is the electronic components that we will be using in this study. So rectifier converts these AC signals to DC signals, and then regulates it to a much more stable signal, DC signal, which can be used. DC to DC boost converter. Now, since piezoelectric transduction gives off a small amount of electricity, a small amount of voltages, we need this component to step up the voltage to charge the battery. The battery charging circuit is the battery charging circuit is also applied or is integrated in the rectifier and this DC boost converter to power up the battery. So there are two types of battery charging circuit. First is the fast charging and the slow charging. Fast charging meaning it has current more than equal or more than 2 amperes of current. And slow charging can be determined as 1 ampere or less. So in this study, we'll be using slow charging, so slow battery charging. So the power storage device that we'll be using is lead acid battery that is 12 volts. It will be discussed later on in the next module. So next, chapter 4.
So, good morning, panels. I will be discussing the chapter 4 of our study, which is the methodology. In this chapter, we concluded from the related literatures to our study to make our design more possible. And each steps will be discussed from the next slide. So this is the overview of our process. The process of our study. First is the proposal of the topic design, which is the this is proposal of our title. Then the next one is the research of possible materials for the platform. For the platform, here we have brainstormed. We have research from the previous literature and studies to relate it in our study. So that part is our brainstorming part. So also in this part, the possible design was made. So could the design withstand the weight of light vehicles? Here in this part is the theoretical question for our design. If no, we will go back to the more, we will need more research for our study. If yes, then we continue with our modeling of the circuit diagram. Here, we have constructed a basic circuit diagram, but when we search for possible components in the market, there's already a pre-made circuits. So the next question is, does the circuit diagram produce the required power output? If yes, then we continue to our material selection. Here we canvas our possible materials that have been made. So then the next question, are the materials economical? Then next one is are the materials available in the local market? This question refers in one of our specific objectives. Then next is the surveying number of vehicles passing through the area. this part is the number of vehicles will be related to the output of our design. So if this will refer to our adjustments in our circuits, if we add more piezoelectric or we adjust minimal adjustment. So next is the fabrication of one speed breaker platform. So in our study, we first made one speed breaker first instead of all of them, so that we could test the capacity that of the 1.5 ton kilogram to be
ton
to be subjected in this design. So installation of the integrated surface, we will install it in our fabricated design. Then testing of one speed breaker. Then can the design platform withstand a lot of the passing light vehicles? If not, in here, if no, we will minor adjustment will be made. If additional spring will be installed or not. If yes, then the other remaining fabrication of the speed breaker will be made. Then testing of the platform, the whole design, then data gathering, then adjustment of the design for the required output from the data. Then the last question, these are our goal. Does the design produce enough energy to power the 10-watt LED street lamp for 12 hours a night? If not, there's a minimal adjustment that will be made. If yes, then our study will be concluded.
So, let's see. Iba kayo simple ba yan?
So, the main materials that will be used in this study is the steel plate, speed breaker, the springs, piezoelectric transducers, the battery, and the speed plate lamps. So, the design of the platform, we canvassed these materials. So we have found the standardized speed breaker, which is 308, 550 mm. Then we needed 5 speed breaker, 5 feet. Five feet by two. So one lane of speed breaker will be 3 pieces of speed breaker. Since we did 5 sets, so that's why it is 15 pieces. Then the second one is the steel plate. There's a standardized steel plate that is available in the market, which is 5 by 10 feet. So fabrication will be made to make it 5 pieces. And this still, the speed breaker will be molded in the steel plate. Then 5 springs each. Speed breakers. Then our initial number of piezoelectric transducer that we'll be making our design is 250 pieces. The piezoelectric transducer can be made stacked. There's a type of piezoelectric transducer that is a stack type, which is the piezoelectric transducer is overlapped with each other. Then each spring will consist 10 pieces of piezoelectric transducer, because this stack type is for the heavy loads. It's for heavy loads application energy harvesting. Then our lead acid battery is 45 ampere hour. Then our load, which is the street lights, will be LED street lights, 12 volts and 10 watts. So next. And this is our proposed design, the street lamps. Then the sizes of this design will be discussed later in the appendices. So here we just label it first. So the speed breaker here, your plate, then the battery housing, the PVC pipe. So next, this is the isometric view. Then next one is the top view. So the ano the steel plate will be connected by trunk lock pin so that the so avoid the misalignment of each steel plate. So next one is the side view. So next. So this is the inside of the piezoelectric the speed pump, speed breaker. So we have this is the hollow part. Fabrication will be made for this speed breaker. So the limiter, we have the limiter, the compression spring, the piezoelectric transducer will be under the spring. The hollow part here under the piezoelectric transducer will be is needed to the hollow part under the piezoelectric transducer is needed to bend to damp the vibration of the piezoelectric transducer for more bending action. So then the circuit diagram, we have here the side circuit diagram and next one. Here we have the energy harvester. This is the general circuit diagram that is needed. But in the market it's already in pre-made. So this is the
energy harvester. 1.7
microfarad. So the other half of the circuit diagram next one will be the DC to DC boost converter. Then this is the other half of the circuit diagram, and in the market there's already a pre-made circuit.
Eh, isa, Mr. Gadia, 100 kasi baba mo. Micron yan.
Yes, sir.
Ang besa yun yun. Micro. Ikaw na po yung presente. Dapat ang party mo yan, alam mo yung pinaglalagay
mo. The inductance, sir.
Ha?
The inductance.
Sabi nila. Very good, hindi mo alam.
Sorry, sir. So, next. So, the half of the methodology will be discussed by Mr. Tan.
Good day, Advisor. So I will now continue the methodology. Next is the fabrication of the design. Cutting of steel from 5x10 to 5 pieces of 5x2 feet. So since the 5x10 feet to 5 pieces of 5x2 feet
down. 5x10 feet. Ano yung 5 pieces tapos 2x2?
5x2 feet.
Puro naman typo. Tapos pinasa yung figure 4.9. Typo rin.
Yes, sir. Ito po yung 4.9.
Oh, wala mo na yung figure. Typo rin yun, typo.
So, other fabrications such as drilling and soldering will be done by the group. So, next is the procedure of testing. Site of testing. The testing will be done in Osmeña Street
Oh, sigot pa nga dyan.
Si...
Yes, sir.
Sir. Ito ba?
Yes, sir.
Batalaga City?
Apo.
Saan ni Cedro?
Apo. Doon po malapit sa Shell. Sa Shell.
Shell?
Shell Refiner.
Ito po yung anak, sino yung nangyari na sa Pugito?
Ano po? Abida.
So... It will be on a residential road in a private village, and the platform will be placed in the entrance, so there will be a lot of cars that will run through the speed train.
Ibig sabihin, i-test ko talaga doon yung gusto niyo doon?
Yes.
E paano yung, ano, yung permission?
May
bilig.
Sa kilala.
Permission?
Doon yung talaga i-test?
So it will be conducted for 12 hours, 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. And it will be observed for 1 week. So, sa...
Oh. The, 6 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Yes.
Ano pag may talaga rin si ano yun, si Gadia? Ayun na rin ko sa ano.
So that's scheduled...
Ibig sabihin, nakahanapin namin yung data ngayon, ha? Sa 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. ha? One week ha? At 12 weeks?
Weekend.
Saturday,
Sunday, and Monday.
Weekend. Hindi, okay, ilang alam niya yung for 1 week eh, oh. Sabi ko, 3 weeks. Type mo na naman yan. Kasi may tandaan lang din ang
So the next is surveying number of vehicles. A survey will be conducted to determine the number of vehicles passing through Osmeña Street on a 12-hour period from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. This will be done by counting the average car that uses that route.
So, hindi, paano yan? Paano yan? Di ba ano yan? Pag nandun na kayo, babantayin nyo, nag-test kayo. Okay. Pwede after counting na?
Yes, sir. Mga data.
Hindi, wala na survey.
Sir, magsusurvey.
Ay, survey po. No,
survey
muna, muna.
Mauna po yung survey pa.
Para may initial data kayo.
Yes,
no?
Sir.
Saan ito? Baka may record. Walang record. Di sa ano?
Tatanong po namin sa association.
To adjustment setup. Adjustment will take place on the event when the springs does not produce oscillation or the output power is less than the expected results. It can be done by adding springs or piezoelectric transducers, changing the time of operation, or relocate to another spring with higher vehicle volume. So this part will be done after the survey and the test. Next is the appendices.
Bale, mangyayari ba dyan? I-install nyo muna yung power na pag-process.
Ano po? Parang survey po tapos...
Hindi yung sa power na mag-process.
Nakaano na.
Bale ba? Bale ba?
Bale, 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. po sir. Dadaan po yung mga sakyan dyan, charging the battery.
Okay, yun nga, sinacharge yung battery.
Okay, then after ng 6 p.m. po, then we'll count 12 hours kung yung power inside the battery will last.
Nagamitin.
Yes, sir.
So, the appendix A, proposed dimension of the design. So, the lamp post will be 8 feet high. So, this is the dimensions of the steel plate. This is the steel plate. The 5 by 10 feet. And it will be cut into 5 by 2 feet. So, there will be a speed breaker on each.
Pero, tansya nyo, mga salapat ng ano, nung road, 5 feet, ano masasakop niya? Kalahati?
One lane.
Kalahati ng isang lane.
Tapos,
kalahati ng road.
Kalahati ng road.
Isang lane masasakop ito.
Bali yung size po niya, refer po namin sa width ng isang vehicle.
Sana pala nabubuhat, no? Kasi kung maraming papasok, nilipad ko sa kapelang.
Hindi, sir. Yun po yung silbi ng 5x2 na steel plate. Bale, pwede po namin siyang ma-disassemble, then i-relocate.
Ah, mabilis.
Kasi portable po siya.
Pero parang mataasan, yung masyadong mataas. Yung ano niya, yung height niya, total height, ilan?
2 feet, sir. Yung speed breaker siya?
Oo.
2 feet. Inches. Sorry, sir.
Gutom lang yan, sir.
2 inches.
2 feet, eh. Iniwasan nung
nakita tayo. Pero, pali yung sinunan ng size nung speed breaker is yung standards po ng isang
speed breaker. 2 inches lang pala yan.
Yes, sir.
Tapos may stopper ka, di ibig sabihin yung deflection ng spring talaga maliit na.
Yes, sir.
Illegal ba yan?
Illegal
springs.
Illegal
yan? Yes, sir. Ah, so maliit na yun, yung deflection, no?
Yes, sir.
Approximately ilan?
Kunti lang naman yung kailangan.
1.75 inch.
Hindi naka-scale ito eh, no? Okay, sa palit lang.
So, this is the gun chart for the study. So, it will take 9 months. Approximately 9 months. So,
9 months? 9 months?
Yes, sir. Starting this quarter. Yes, sir.
Ah, January?
Yes, sir.
Yung nakaka 3 months na?
Okay.
6 months na lang?
Yes,
sir. Approximately. Ka pa si Gadia, no? 6 months.
So, these are the estimated cost and list of material. The speed breaker cost 12,000 pesos, 800 pesos each. And we will buy 15 pieces of it. Next is the piezoelectric transducer. It is 14 pesos each and we are going to buy 250 pieces. Next is the steel plate, the 5x10 feet. It costs 12,000 pesos. Next is the LED street lamp bulb. The approximate cost is 4,000 pesos. The bolts and nuts are provided by our roommate. The compression spring is yung bolts and nuts na gagamitin.
Provided by your roommate?
Mr. Tamse.
Bakit may tindahan mo sila?
The auto-supply.
Anong tindahan niya? May pagpumili si advisor.
Next is the compression spring, 25 pieces, and it's going to cost 4,500 pesos. The rubber is 1,400 pesos. The PVC pipe, 1 inch diameter, 10 feet, costs 270 pesos. The wires and the motor light battery are also provided. And the trunk lock pin is 1,600 pesos. The energy harvester costs 1,925 and the DC to DC booster is 349 pesos. The proposed budget is 42,000.
Tapos sila kayo, 245?
Yeah.
So,
that's all good.